Hello there, my Lindys friends, it's Asia Marke here, Lemon Creation, today with new art journal spread and the technique which I called mirror paint application, so stay tuned! I am starting with absorbent ground, so I'm gonna cover both pages with this paste. You can of course use gesso. Absorbent ground gives you a nicer color. When you apply the color to on the ground like that, on the base like that, the colors will not dull, while gesso is giving you a little bit more dullish color, I find, or less brighter. So that's the new buy I did recently because I heard only good things about it. I'm gonna do some comparison on my channel, I think, soon or on Instagram, so you can check that out. And after this absorbent ground is dry, I'm gonna add the paint. This time I'm using only Magic Art, but of course you can use whichever paint you want. So, you know, you can mix and match, you can use some Magic Art, some sprays, wherever you want. And this is the, or these were the colors I used for this project. So, I am not gonna dilute them first with water. I wanted to get a little bit of madness on my page, in madness in a very good sense, a little bit of magic. And so, I am spraying, no, not spraying, I'm actually applying the colors with the brush over the wet surface. And I chose the palette which is very, I don't know, summery. Blues, teals, and a little bit of green. And as you can see, I'm just applying wherever I want. I didn't spray all the page with water because I wanted to keep my negative space, white space. And I prefer it this way. And now I'm just using a little bit of water. My mini mister didn't work here well, so I used the bigger bottle, bigger sprayer. And now that's the trick, you just turn the page, so for this project you need to have two pages, and then you open it, and you have your mirror paint application. So as you can see, the both sides are perfect, they match, they are the same, well, with a, you know, small difference in paint, but in general they are the same. And that's the whole trick, that's it basically. So you can use it on both sides of your art journal page, or you can just take two pieces of paper and just do on two pieces of paper, for example, making two exactly the same projects. Why not? That could be really nice also. And sometimes when you struggle with a paint application, you don't know what to put where, this is also a way to go, you know. You just make one side, you put it, you know, you squeeze the pages together and you put on the second side, and like that you have something new and unique. And as you've seen, I used my stencil with black soot distress oxide, and I stencil a little in the background, and now I'm using a collage paper by Tim Holtz. That's the first time I'm using that, and I have to tell you, this paper is really, really good. I'm using matte gel to apply it, and it sticks very well to the surface, and it gives you the impression that it was always there. You don't have the hard edges, that's why the collage paper is so good. I find it really good, you know, you don't have these edges, edges. If you would use a piece of, I don't know, newspaper on the or a book, you would get the edges there, but like that it kind of melts into the background, which is super cool. And I really like it because, you know, it has this old kind of type of letters and numbers also, so, you know, this is my thing. And now I'm gonna be stamping a little bit. And I use the glitch stamp from Tim Holtz also, Stampers Anonymous. And this time I am actually using archival ink. Yes, it's archival ink or Stazon maybe. So sorry, I don't know why I didn't show it. I tried to show all the products I'm using on the camera. This time I kind of, I don't know, forgot. But basically That's what I'm doing, and the reason for doing that with the Stazon or archival ink is simple, because they will not run if you add later a little bit water. I didn't plan on adding water, yet again at the end I add a little bit of splatter with Lindys, you're gonna see it. And that's always risky if you use ink which is not permanent, you know, the thing can run a little and it can waste the page. But the only thing I used was the distress oxide, which is not totally permanent, and it didn't really affect the page at the end. And those are my focal plants, my tree birds. I absolutely love them. They are birds which comes from Alexandra Renke, and they are really, really nice. She has beautiful papers, stamps and dies and a lot of other things. But I really love them and I use them on few projects already, I think. So as you can see, I'm edging the, or maybe you cannot see really because I'm again off the camera a little, but I was edging the you know, the shapes of the, or the edges of the birds with the ink also and sponge. And now I'm adding a little bit of interest to the page again with a washi tape this time. And this washi tape, it's also the first time I'm using it. It's a washi tape from All and Create. I will add two different washi tapes from All and Create. I really love them, but I don't like the even edges, so I always tear them. I like that. I find that it's more grungy. If your washi tape doesn't hold well in place, which is very often the case of washi tapes, you just can use a glue, or in my case I was reusing again the mud gel from Pebble. Now I am adding a little bit of splatter, not too much this time, with a blazing black spray from Lindy's Gang, just to make it more grungy, of course. And that would be one of the last steps in this art journal. I will glue my birds with the foam tape, so like that they are not flat on the page, they are kind of sticking out again for more interest and more levels. And you will see me soon enough changing my mind about one of the birds. I kind of didn't like the way it looked. I thought that it's not a good color for the page, but that in a moment. I'm adding now of course the sentiment, which comes from my super messy words. I'm adhering it to the page with Nuvo Deluxe Glue, which is super good glue, and it has very fine nib, so you can actually work on a very small intricate paper elements. And a little bit of doodling on the edges, so like that my page will look not so bare in the places when there is negative white space. Just really, you know, I'm going really with a very freehand, but making just these borders to kind of put the whole page together by using the black marker. And ta-da! In a second you're gonna see me actually taking away the bird from the page. I was lucky enough that the foam tape didn't stick too well to the page, so I managed to take it out and I used the small bird I found in my stash. I was thinking I don't have any more orangey birds, but I did. And I thought then that now actually the page looks much better than with the, you know, with the pink one. That's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. And if you want to know exactly the products I used, they are on Lindy's blog, so you can check them there. And I hope I'm gonna see you soon. Have a lovely day. Bye bye.